friend named Lewis. His friend comes in the room dragging the blanket. Come on, help me out. And he goes in the room and the room is dark. But Lewis comes in and he opens up the curtains and he lets the sunlight in and looks at Charlie and says, "You fell today, but the sun is still shining. I gotta get out of here." And some of you who've been down so long, you don't realize there's a new day. We been broke for a night, but there you go. They're making me work too hard in here. Comes in the morning. I find your neighbor, say, "Neighbor, I got joy on the inside. Because there is a brighter day." Come on, touch somebody, get them by the hand and say, "Neighbor, there is a brighter day. The sun is still shining in my life. I've been going through some stuff, but the sun is still shining." We gotta get out of here. Let me get you some text. Sit down here now. The text will teach us to tell us something here. We see Jay Bass here. I like Jay Bass because he prays the right prayer. Number one, we see that he prays a personal prayer. Somebody say personal prayer. Some of you got to understand, you got to know how to have a personal relationship with God. I know the church now knows how to pray for you, but there's going to be a time that none of us are in here, and you got to learn how to pray. Somebody say personal prayer. Watch this here. He gets personal, canon, because he understands his God of Israel. He said, "Now I know who my God is. I know my mother put some stuff over my life, and she gave me a name. But I want you to understand something. I know a God that knows all about me." So I can imagine Jabez got on his knees and he began to talk to God. Look at what Jabez says. He said, "Oh, that you would bless me indeed." Now, number one, we see he has a personal prayer life. But then when he's praying, he asks for a provision. Somebody say provision. Now, look what it is when he asks for provision. He says, "Now, I don't mean to be selfish, but sometimes I gotta be selfish for myself." And watch what he is when he's praying. He asks God for personal prayer. He asks God, watch this, for provision. But then he was specific. He says, "Now I want you to do something. Enlarge my territory." In other words, blow me up, Lord. I want you to blow me up so much that my haters gotta look at me and say, "How did you get to the place that you are right now?" Look at somebody and lift your hand and say, "Lord, blow me up." I want somebody in here to understand God is about to blow you up. Did you hear what I said? He's about to blow you up. Eyes have not seen, ears have not heard. He's about to blow you up. Look at somebody, hop out your neighbor, say, "Neighbor, I'm not going to need money. I'm not going to need men. But I got the God of man." Look at somebody, say, "He's about to blow me up. He's about to blow me up." And I like him because he's asking God to blow him up. Look what the text says. He says, "That your hand will be with me." Now we understand, my brothers and preachers, we understand that now that he prays for God's presence, we see in the text here from a theological platform. Access the geomistic hand whenever the Bible speaks of some anatomical body part. It talks of God's hand. When we see here the anthropological metaphor speaking in human terms, so we understand something here. God is never recognized, but he's always revealed. So the hand really means God's power. Somebody said God's power. Some of you can't understand. I can't see him, but I can feel him every now and then. That's what Jeremiah said. He said, I almost was going to give up, but something happened on the inside. I was about to turn in my resignation, and something happened. Jeremiah said it was like fire. Look at somebody and say, neighbor, he's never recognized, but he's always revealed. So we see here, Jabez made a petition before the Lord. But I like what he says when I get out of here. He said, that you may keep me from evil, that I might not cause pain. He said, I know my name is pain, but I don't want to cause nobody else pain. You know what he's saying here? He said, Lord, let the generational curse stop right here. I don't want it to be passed to my children. I don't want it to be passed to my grandchildren. But stop right here. Cause somebody say, neighbor, he prayed for protection. He said, do not say, Lord, keep me from evil, but keep me from evil. Because Jabez says, I know who I am. I'm a messed up person. And sometimes I'm dangerous. But I ask God to keep me from evil. Shake your neighbor by the hand and say, neighbor, I'm asking God for more. Come on, shake somebody by the hand and say, neighbor, learn how to pray with passion. Learn how to pray with power. Come on, Will, let's ride. Shake your neighbor by the hand and say, neighbor, I don't know what you came to do, but I came to lift him up. I came to magnify him. He said, if I be lifted up, I draw all men unto me. Now Jabez, he had to pray. He said, Jabez called on the God of Israel. Somebody said prayer. But then he prayed with passion. Oh, that you will bless me indeed. So he prayed. Then he prayed with passion. But then he prayed with purpose. He said, enlarge my coast, my territory. Look at somebody and say, neighbor, give me some room, because God is about to enlarge my territory. Is there anybody here that can understand that God is about to enlarge your territory? Is there anybody in here that can testify you've been through some stuff, but after all you've been through, you still have the joy? James says, we have not because we ask not. But Matthew 7:7 says, ask and seek and knock, and the door shall be opened.
You're asking God to move in a mighty way.
Yes, Lord.
To move in your life.
Move, Jesus. Hallelujah.
To enlarge your territory. To blow you up. God is not going to give you anything if you stay stuck in your pain. Let's say it very quickly. A lot of us love being stuck in the situation where we are.
That's right. All right.
But God has so much more for us.
Amen.
Don't allow your pain to determine your destiny. That means we're standing. Everyone get up.
All right.
Don't allow your pain So many people like being stuck in their situation. But look at somebody again and say, God has more for you. I know people say, I got age on my side, I'm getting older, I'm gonna quit. God says, I got more for you. You can use that age stuff as a cop-out. But God has more for you. Let me ask you a question. Are you still breathing?
Yeah.
You barely got to church, but you're still here, right?
Yeah.
That means he got more for you. God has more for you. That's why we always say there is no secret. What God can do, what he's done for others, he'll do the same for you. Put your hands together and give God a praise, because if you believe God has done more for you. Very quickly, tell somebody and say, neighbor, do you know Jesus Christ? Do you know Jesus Christ? We offer Christ. We offer.